The Garden of Eden story and the emergence of the demon. Humanity is living out the drama of the Garden of Eden story. Adam and Eve have been the catalyst of everything. But what really happened? What is the truth behind the Adam and Eve saga? In the Old Testament, mentions is made of Adam's first wife, known as Jezebel, who was known as Inanna by the ancient Sumerians. I wrote a book on the subject entitled, Subliminal Desire. You can buy it online at a reasonable price. The book traces the origin and history of lustful demons. Please click like and you can subscribe to my channel, The Paranormal Life Channel. You can engage with me, my email is below. When looking back at the origin of evil and lustful demons, we see Inanna rebelled against Adam, because she wanted to be equal, not subservient. She refused to lie underneath, according to ancient tradition. She left the Garden of Eden and roamed the earth. The Sumerian records indicate Inanna was a demon. She has many names in different cultures and through time. Legend has it Lilith, the demon incubus, was the same person as Inanna. The left path recognizes Lilith as a female demon queen, supreme to all demons. She is the queen succubus demon, whom followers of the left-hand path beseech her to send her daughters for the activity of demon sex. Both male and female on the left-hand path call upon Lilith to send her daughters and sons for demon sexual gratification. The process engaging the great queen Lilith has been carved centuries back and left in written texts known as grimoire. It is through the grimoire which demon sex with humans are constructed. The seeker of sex with an incubus, male demon, and succubus, female demon, will follow a regulated and structured procedure as recorded in ancient grimoire. The seeker of demon sex will write a letter to Lilith and sign a contract with his or her blood. Other magic spells and invocation are also employed. People who conducted the procedure reported in obtaining results either in their sleep or while fully awake. Personally, I'm of the opinion, the demonic forces of the left-hand path are only too willing to be of help in exchange for your soul. The left-hand path is a road often traveled, because it yields quick results. Much of the procedure has been lost, but those of the left-hand path are certain they have reawakened the phenomenon. Not all demons are evil. Demons are almost similar to humans and also have families. Demons are comprised of different groups and different races and sub-races. They are originally an extra-universe species. They entered this universe from outside this universe, according to ancient tradition. This universe appears to be infinite. There are infinite universes outside this universe. There are infinite realms within a single confined space. Demons have the ability to traverse through space and time, and they are multidimensional creatures. They can shape-shift into almost any form, and they can teleport themselves into our domain as well as into our past and into our future time. There are different types of demonic beings, but the common demons are known as the reptilian demons. The succubus and incubus demons are most often cat-like. In my own experience, demons appear animal equals like in form. The presence of the reptilian demons were first recorded by the Sumerians. The ancient Egyptians referred to these reptilian demons as archons. Arab folk refer to these demons as jinn. In the West, these demons have also become folklore. In the Arabian Nights fables, you find the genie in the bottle who will serve his master, and he always says, "Your wish is my command." King Solomon, the prophet of ancient Jerusalem, wielded the power of the jinn and other types of demons. The history of man is the history of demons. Demons have been in intimate relation with humankind since the advent of Adam and Eve. The story of the Garden of Eden does not end there. It does not even start there. What we believe of the Garden of Eden is what is found in Scripture. But what is found in Scripture is not the whole truth and is misunderstood. The basic question remaining is, where was the Garden of Eden? Was it somewhere in heaven? This notion of a heavenly Garden of Eden is the common belief. But according to written records left behind in the Sumerian clay tablets, the Garden of Eden was a simple place on earth, in the vicinity between the Euphrates and Tigris rivers. It was here where Adam and Eve were hybridized as the servants of the Inanna, who came to earth in search of gold to repair their atmosphere around planet Nibiru. The Anunna or Anunnaki were human-looking, but partly reptilian demons, and they were giants. The truth can be seen all over ancient paintings and sculptures. Demons have a close tie with the Anunna as well as other unknown demonically inclined types. These demons are highly, explicitly sexual. They prey on sexual beasts the same way we prey on nourishment. These demonic entities are being partly nourished by the sex energy humans emit, and they are almost always present during sexual performances. Even if you are unaware of the demon presence, evil has to be rewritten. Our traditional understanding of evil and demons is a static worldview based on outdated viewpoints. Much of our understanding of demons are biblical and scriptural and not entirely the truth. We associate evil and demons together and class these as the ultimate expression of what we think evil is. Not all demons are evil, though. What is a demon really? The answer cannot be categorized in a single conception. Demons are also associated with reptiles, with bad deeds among a variety of negative connotations. The idea of evil emerged with the story of the Garden of Eden and with the fallen angels. History ought to be rewritten after the discovery of the Dead Sea Scrolls and the translations of the clay tablets of Sumer. Demons are not actually classified as a single phenomenon. Demons are a variety of races, sub-races, and cross-species. They come in a variety of forms and they exist in various realms, dimensions, and universes. Why do demons plague humans? Why do demons mislead humans? Why do demons have sex with humans while they are asleep? These are the types of questions this work addresses. Paranormal sexual relations is not a new thing at all. It has been occurring for thousands of years since ancient times. There is not a single person on earth who has not experienced a dirty dream of some sort. Most often a person's dreams were invaded by otherworldly entities.